Okay, would you like to see a magic trick?
Always.
Okay, so these are a set of four little sticks that I've got here. They've got numbers on them. They're called the mental logs. And I'm going to use them to do a super fast mental calculation, which I'm sure you'll enjoy very much. So you're allowed to order these in whatever order you want to, so...
Let's swap the middle two and then like the end two.
And this end?
Both the ends.
Both end twos. Okay, that one and that one. Yep. So they've got four faces on each one. So what do you want to do?
I want to turn the first one one.
Like that?
Yep. The second one the other way.
Yep.
And the other two, I want to flip completely 180.
Okay, like that and like that.
Yeah.
So you've now created four-digit numbers across the top. So you've got 4,959 across the top there, and then three other numbers as well. And I would like you to add up those four numbers.
49, 59. Oh, I'm not going to tell you this.
49. Okay, I'll stop you there. Before you press equals, I'm going to tell you the total is going to be 22,486.
Whoa, let's see about that. Oh, okay. Yeah, it was.
It's a magic trick. So this is a nice little... It's actually a really classic magic trick. It's a thing you can buy in magic shops, and it's 100% maths, and it's just... it's adorable. Once you figure out how this works, it's actually super easy to do, and the maths is really, really satisfying the way that it actually works. So, I mean, if people want to try and figure out how this works, you can have a look at them, you can look at the numbers on them. They've all got different sets of numbers on each side. The numbers, it doesn't really matter what they are, but there is a pattern to it. So you might be able to look at some of those and maybe spot some of the patterns in there, but I will explain what it is that's going on here. So on here, these numbers have been chosen very carefully. So the third number there is the one that I'm interested in, and that's the one that I use to work out the total of all the others. So in fact, I can do this with fewer than four. I can do it with two rods instead. So if I pick these two rods like this, I would say the total there is 275. And the reason I know that is because I'm taking this number, I'm putting a two at the start, taking this number, and then minus two from that one. If I had these three rods together, I would say the total is 2,777, because I'm putting a two at the start and I'm subtracting two from that last number. And in fact, if I take these and change them so that they're all facing different ways like that.
So there we'll have 2,755.
Yep. So that'll be the total for those. And you can do it with one. So the total there would be 21, because I put a two at the start and I subtract two from the last digit. And the reason why this works is just lovely. So if you look at the numbers on here, the numbers except for that third one will always add up to the same total. So here I've got 4, 9 and 5, total of 18. Again, here I've got 9, 4 and 5. Here I've got 3, 7 and 8, total of 18. And again, 3, 8 and 7. And the same thing works on any one of these. So there I've got 8, 3 and 7, total 18. 7, 2 and 9, total 18. And that will always work. And what this means is that if you have your four columns of numbers and you're adding them all together, you get 18 in each of the three columns plus whatever that extra digit is. So what I'm essentially adding up is whatever the number in the third row is, and we'll come back to that later, but
I've got
18.
I'm going to do this one, Katie.
Yep.
So this one is 22722.
Yep.
Okay.
Okay, so you'll get a five-digit number if you've got four columns. So what I've essentially got here is I've got 18 in the right-hand column, and in this column I've got 18 again, but because it's the tens column, I've effectively got 180. And in the next column, I've got 1,800. And in the next column, I've got 18,000. And if I add all of those together, some live maths, live very, very easy maths, I get this. And this number is 20,000 minus 2. So if I take this row, which is the only row I haven't used yet, add 20,000 and subtract 2, I'll get the same as if I'd added up all of the numbers. And in that case, it's the same as putting a two at the start and then minusing two from the number at the end. So that's really nice. And this is why it works with any number of columns as well, because the exact same thing happens. I put, I just don't have this here, so I'd have 1998 and the same thing would work. And also, there's an extra hidden thing built into these, which I think is quite nifty, which is that if you put the rods in this order, I can tell you the total on the back is 28,632.
Flip them around.
So if I flip those over, you can see I've got my 8634, which gives me 28,632. But in fact, this number here is the same as this number here, and this number here is the same as this number here. So they've deliberately, because of course all you need is for those three to add up to 18, you've got a bit of flexibility in there. They've deliberately made it so that whatever this number is, it's the same as that one. So if I want to do the back, I just look at this number read backwards. So they're 22,722.
I do always enjoy checking in to see what brilliant.org's problem of the week is. There's a basic, intermediate, and advanced. Let's go for the basic one, hey? It says here, Rakesh's spam filter predicts whether or not an email is spam. It is accurate 98% of the time, and he knows that 1% of the emails sent to him are spam. Only 1%, I dream of that. Which is more likely to be true if he receives an email that his filter predicts is spam? The email is spam, or the email is not spam? While you think about that, I'd like to thank Brilliant for sponsoring this video. Brilliant.org is a website full of quizzes and puzzles and courses you can go through to get a better understanding of things like mathematics, physics, computer science. They've got brilliant stuff, and by doing all these quizzes and puzzles and sort of working your way through it, you really get a better understanding of mathematics. Not just memorizing things or being told things you have to know, but encouraging critical thinking. Really getting an understanding for things. Go and have a look at the website, and if you go to brilliant.org/numberphile, that link's also in the video description, you can get 20% off Brilliant's premium membership. And let's see if I'm ready for these intermediate and advanced. Oh, the intermediate one's got a snowman.